Sugimoto Showcase. Ladies and gentlemen, he is back. He has been buffed and he's still garbage. I've always had mixed opinions about him because he's such a cool character. He got some pretty substantial buffs. The main thing being is his passive. I recommended like a long time ago. I don't think it was ever in a video. It was just like whenever me and my friends were talking about him. Well, what happened was with Sugimoto the Immortal's passive before is that he would revive his own self with max HP and max art gauge. The art's damage would be increased by 50% and crit rate 100% for 30 seconds after reviving. You can do it only twice. However, what they don't tell you in this passive, I don't know why they didn't word it here. It is extremely important. This passive can reset if he gets revived another way. So let's say if he gets revived from Blessed Necklace or from Fina's passive or any other passive in the game, like Thetis's passive or something, he will be able to reset his revives. So let's say you use two of them, you get revived by Blessed Necklace, then boom, you can use two of them again. From what I've heard, that's how it works. I haven't tested this myself, however, because I realized something. In this day and age, it's so hard for you to kill a unit. Like, I have to do some pretty hard content for him to die, which at that point I don't think it's really worth it for him to do that. Actually, what am I talking about? There is an item called B3 Claw, ladies and gentlemen. We're gonna let Sugimoto die this way. And how are we gonna make sure that happens? It's because we're gonna use True Izanagi at the same time on Sugimoto. So this way, we get the equipped CT down, we take all the damage, and we make sure that he dies. Is this the brightest idea I ever had? No. This will prove if it's worth it to kill Sugimoto or not. Or if it's worth it just to use a different DPS unit. And I'm actually recording this on, what was today? Tuesday? Wednesday? Thursday. Friday. Thursday. I'm recording it Thursday at 4:30 in the morning, and the plan Crest Palace is here. This could either be a disaster or the biggest brain play I've ever made. The only problem we have currently is I forgot to put on Keratos. And the other problem is that I don't know if using grief will be enough to kill him. Never mind. Highly overestimated his defense. He's already about to die. And you know, now come to think about it, we have so much equip CT on this team because if I can get a Serpa's True Art off as well, there should be no way Sugimoto survives. I hope, at least. There shouldn't be, right? I think the main problem is that Serpa may be the bad part about this team, because she is the only one that can keep Sugimoto alive during all this nonsense. So here we go, lads, here we go. If possible, we will use Sugimoto's True Art because we don't really care. Because, you know, he's gonna die and he's gonna be able to put back up his buffs. It's happening. The thing that I didn't want to happen is currently happening, where everybody else on the team is dying apart from Sugimoto. Like, it doesn't make sense, bruh. As soon as we start healing, everything goes to shit. Which, you know what? I have an idea now. Now, since I said, I'm just gonna let Sugimoto die. I'm not even gonna do anything else. I'm not even gonna pop anything else for anybody. I'm just gonna let him die. And unfortunately, he has died. And also, my Serpa has died, which is very bad, because now we're gonna see if Sugimoto was worth it. And now looking at him, look at him right there. Now, he's actually by himself. Can he solo this? I don't think he can. Dude. Okay, round two. So we did actually get Sugimoto's immortal proc to actually go off, which means now, if we can get to the boss extremely quick, we have 30 seconds. 30 seconds of this buff, we're on stage fucking 5. And boom, I think we've got here. We still have the crit buff up, I think. Yeah, we do. So if everything goes as planned, Berwick and Sugimoto should be able to kill all the adds right here. Should be. Hopefully. Please. For the love of God. If they can both kill all the adds, and then Sugimoto should be able to do the big deeps, hopefully, and killed the actual boss, I think. So let's see. Sugimoto still has his crit buff. He has the 100% physical damage up. For the love of God, Sugimoto, do something, please. Okay, Sugimoto, I see you. But now it sucks because you lost your buff. You lost your buff, lad. Oh no. And we've gotten, oh no. Oh God, we're getting spam silenced. I don't like this. Oh Lord. And this is the only part that I think is bad about Sugimoto, is that the whole focus for the unit is to die. There's so many comps. Like, there's not a comp in GS that is like a zombie comp. The whole team is meant to die to an extent and then come back to life. I think One Piece Treasure Cruise has like zombie comps and stuff. They're not like meant to die. I think they're just, they heal a lot or something. I was never too big into that game, so I'm not for sure. But in GS, there's no type of like zombie comp, which means that I think Sugimoto being a unit that just dies and comes back isn't good enough. I think if anything, it's an added bonus for him. But you did see in that, you saw his damage. I think he was hitting for what, 163,000 per stab. So he does 5 strikes. Like, all of them were hitting for like 163,000 with his crit buff, his art damage buff, and then also Swick's 100% physical damage up. And I feel like for the most part, you're gonna be wanting to run him on a team with just a crit buffer. And if you build a team specifically around him, it won't work out too well. I would say he is usable in most parts of the game, but not as what they want you to do. And unfortunately, there's no like item in the game that's just like, hey, let me just just insta-kill my unit. Pretty much B3 Claw is the best thing we have, or something like that. However, you know where he is good at? Arena. This guy, if you just started playing the game, you got Sugimoto, put this man on your arena team. Screw items, screw everything. Put this man on your arena team, your whole team dies. Who cares? This man comes back to life, you pop his true art, he kills the entire team. Arena, though, is like such a side thing in GS to where it doesn't matter whatsoever after you get like all the rewards. But I mean, hey, if you just started playing the game, really good arena unit. He can hard carry you through all of arena. But guys, gonna be it for the video. I try my best. We got him to die. We saw the damage. We just didn't kill the boss, which is I think the worst part. There may be other comps I could have did, but unfortunately everybody that has a revive like built into their kit is usually people that can keep their team alive. I think in the future though, if GS ever gets more support for like a zombie team where we have units that want to die and they work together, maybe where one unit maybe takes the HP of like all the other units, so where they can die faster and maybe buff up that one unit itself, that would be a really cool like idea, like maybe a vampire unit that feeds off the HP of his allies and then possibly also has a revive built into him, and we get like some type of zombie team. That may be where Sugimoto comes back, but for right now he doesn't really have a place. But in the future, if there's a unit that comes out like that, then I will definitely show him off again on that team. But guys, that's gonna be it for the video, man. Thank you all for coming out. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe for more. And last but not least, man, you guys already know what to do. Don't forget to drink water.